A lot of people aren't aware how much stress affects their musculoskeletal system. So I just want to show you a few examples so that you're aware of this mind-body connection. So the next time you have aches and pains, you can think rather than, oh, I must be out of alignment, that maybe you've got stress that is causing the problem instead. So let's get Ashley just into a stress posture. And we all know, are aware of a stress posture. It's this rounding of the upper back. The arms come across the body. It's protecting the organs, isn't it? So she's bringing the arms across because that gives her protection just like any animal. It's like, I need to protect my organs from threat. So she's bringing those arms across. She's bringing her shoulders forward, away from the rib cage. Her upper back is rounding forward as well, and her head's coming forward. Her head coming forward is to grit her teeth. Like you see with animals, they grit their teeth, they bite down. That's a protection posture against impending threat as well. And let's look at this from the side. Do you mind turning to the side? So you can see this upper back being rounded, her head forward, jaw tensing. Now when her upper back rounds forward, her pelvis rotates down at the front, up at the back, and she arches her lower back. That's not always a result of the upper back, because animals and humans as well need to protect their genitalia when we're under threat. So what we do is we actually pull them behind us. Animals get the benefit of being on all fours, so their genitalia are protected because obviously they've got their arms in front of them and their jaw. But as humans, all our organs and genitalia are facing the world or the threat that's coming towards us. So the way to protect it is to bring our arms across in front of us and to tilt our pelvis down at the front, up at the back, which then protects our genitalia because it moves it back. So now we can see that stressed posture, which is head forward, shoulders rounded, lower back arched, and pelvis rotated down the front, up at the back. Now, you're like, so what? How does that affect the body? Well, over time, that causes myofascial changes, which is muscle and soft tissue changes, which can cause pain. For example, if Ashley arches her lower back for extended periods of time, these muscles in the lumbar region become tight and restricted, and then that can put pressure on the nerves of the lower back and cause pain. It can also compress the intervertebral discs of the back, which can cause degeneration over time, cause pain. In her upper body, if her upper back and shoulders are rounded forward, her head goes forward, that causes neck tension, obviously shoulder tension. If she faces the camera for us, with her arms being across the body, that causes internal rotation of the arm, which can cause shoulder dysfunction, problems to the rotator cuff muscles of the shoulder. The list goes on. But all those myofascial changes are a result of stress causing structural changes, which is that protective posture, which then spells pain for us as the body adapts and the muscles get tight and restricted as a result. So next time you have pain, don't automatically think, oh, it's because I did too much gardening or whatever it is. Think, what's stressing me out and what can I do about it so that I can improve my posture and body alignment, because now I'm no longer stressed and having to protect myself. And as a result, my muscles and soft tissue structures will relax and I'll feel a lot better as a result.